Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us see the time convolution theorem. So as we all know that the convolution is a bit complex, as we need to verify for each and every point, it's going to be really a complex thing. So that's the reason why the convolution can be done using Fourier transform or set transform. So let us assume the time convolution theorem. Fourier transform of x1 of t is x1 of omega, and Fourier transform of x2 of t is x2 of omega. So then the convolution between x1 of t and x2 of t is x1 of omega into x2 of omega. Here it is multiplication and here it is convolution. So now I hope everyone got a small idea. So now our goal is to prove this. So we all know that the Fourier transform of f of x. So we know that Fourier transform of f of x is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity f of x e to the power of minus j omega t dt. Right guys? Okay. So now let us substitute this whole part as f of t. F is equals to x1 of t into x2 of t is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of t into x2 of t e to the power of minus j omega t. I'll be calling this as into guys because I'm highly habituated for it. Fine. So we all know that the x1 of t convolution x2 of t is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of m into x2 of t minus m. This we have discussed in our first lecture guys. So if you didn't like listen that lecture, please go back and listen that lecture and come back here. So this is this. So we'll be substituting this in place of that. So we got Fourier, okay, that is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of m into x2 of t minus m. So we'll be assuming this as a letter k. So indirectly t minus m is equals to k, where t is equals to k plus m, dt is equals to dm. So that is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity. Again we got integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of m into x2 of k into e to the power of minus j k plus m. So here we are having m, here we are having k, and here we are having k, we are having m. So pair them up and divide them. So integral minus infinity to infinity, integral minus infinity to infinity x2 of k into e to the power of minus j omega k dk into x1 of m into e to the power of minus j omega m dm, that is equals to x1 of omega into x2 of omega, hence proved. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea on time convolution theorem. Guys, I thought to complete the frequency convolution theorem also in this tutorial itself, but I was unable to find the exact derivation. So once I find it, I will be uploading a video or I will be posting the theorem in the community tab. And if you are interested, you can join my WhatsApp group. I'll be providing you the link in the description, and each and every updates will be posted in the WhatsApp group and in the community tab. So please be in touch with any one of them. Okay guys, thank you. Thanks for watching.